Hello, good morning dear students. We are discussing chapter locomotion and movement. Okay, today we can discuss about mechanism of muscle contraction. As shown here, the mechanism of muscle contraction is occurring. So here you can see that this picture, that is myosin and actin, okay, it's a complex protein, you know that muscle protein, that is myosin and actin, okay, actin filament, then myosin filament, ATP is converted to ADP and inorganic phosphate, then formation of cross bridge myosin head and cross bridge formation, then sliding rotation and myosin releasing ADP and inorganic phosphate, then by binding of ATP cross bridge is breaking of cross bridge. Okay, these events. So let us see the what are the events happening during muscle contraction. Okay, the theory related to muscle contraction is sliding filament theory. Sliding filament theory. In 1954, Andrew F. Huxley and Rolf Niederkerke proposed the sliding filament theory to explain muscle contraction. Okay, sliding filament theory. Here we can see that a unit, that is sarcomere, the central line we can call as M line, and that is through middle part of thick filament and middle part of thin filament. There is a fibrous line, that is Z disc or Z line. Okay, this is thick filament and this is thin filament, you see, thin filament and thick filament. Between a middle part of thick filament, there is M line, and non overlapping region, that is H zone. Okay, so I band and A band, clear. It's already you studied that. In the center of each I band is an elastic fiber called Z line, which bisects it. Where is Z line? This is a Z line. Where is Z line? Okay. So actually, the center of each I band is an elastic fibers called Z line, which bisects it. The thin filament are firmly attached to the Z line. The function of Z line is that the thin filament are firmly attached to Z line. Thin filaments attached. Okay. So before we are discussing muscle contraction, we have to see the basic things, basic structure of muscle. Okay, then the thick filament in the A band are also held together in the middle of this band by a thin fibrous membrane called M line. Okay, this is M line, thick band, middle part of thick band has fibrous line, that is called as M line. The thick filament in the A band are also held together in the middle of the band by a thin fibrous membrane called M line. A band, anisotropic band, that is myosin. Okay. Then the A and I band are arranged alternately throughout the length of the myofibrils. The portion of the myofibrils between two successive Z line, the portion of myofibril between two successive Z line is called as sarcomere, clear. Two successive Z line is called as sarcomere. Z line is considered as the functional unit of contraction and is called sarcomere. Okay, sarcomere. So, okay, this also we know that myosin filament, actin filament, tropomyosin, troponin, actin, etc. are muscle protein. Okay, present here. Then myosin has cross arm, that is heavy myosin and light myosin, etc. Okay, actually troponin and tropomyosin has regulatory protein, that is held for masking and unmasking. Okay, the binding site, then also keep in mind this Z line, this is A band, thick band, A band, and thick band, A band, then I band, anisotropic, isotropic band, I band, thin band. Okay. This is A band, this is A band, that is myosin. Okay. And this is I band, that is actin. That's it, actin. Z line, middle part of middle to that is I band, that is called as Z line. Then non overlapping edge zone. Then this unit between two Z line, that is called as sarcomere. Clear? Okay. This shown that two sarcomere, how two sarcomere is changing in shape after contraction. This is relaxed state, two sarcomere, relaxed state. Okay. This is contracting, then maximally contracted state. So we can see the size is reducing between two sarcomere, size is reducing. Clear? This is after contracted state, this is before contraction. H zone, we can H zone is visible, H zone. Okay, but here H zone is not visible. Clear? Okay. So this this process we have to discuss in muscle contraction. Okay. These all are the events we can see after discussion. Okay, myosin split ATP and become reoriented and energized. Myosin head bind to actin forming cross bridge. ADP, adenosine diphosphate, is producing that ATP breakdown into ADP. Okay, then myosin head rotate towards center of the sarcomere or power stalk is called as. Then as myosin head bind ATP, the cross bridge detach from actin. ATP, when ATP is binding, detach. Okay, then next binding of actin myosin. So as I told you, the sliding filament theory, according to this theory, contraction of a muscle fiber takes place by the sliding of the thin filament over the thick filament. What is contraction of muscle fiber take place by the sliding of the thin filament over the thick filament? Where is the thin filament and thick filament? This is thick filament, myosin. This is thin filament. Okay. So sliding of the thin filament over the thick filament. Thin filament over the thick filament. Clear? That is sliding filament theory. Overlapping actin and myosin filaments of fixed length slide past one another in an energy requiring process resulting in muscle contraction. We can see that which energy result requiring process, what happening, ATP hydrolysis, etc. We will discuss. Okay. Muscle contraction is initiated by a signal sent by the central nervous system, CNS, by motor neuron. Okay, through motor neuron, muscle contraction is initiated by a signal sent by the central nervous system by a motor neuron, CNS. Then a motor neuron along with the muscle fibers connected to it constitute a motor unit. What is motor unit? A motor neuron along with the muscle fibers connected to it constitute a motor unit. So you know that that is synapse and neuromuscular junction or motor end plate. Synapse is the gap between two neuron. Okay, motor end plate or neuromuscular junction is the junction or gap between neuron and muscle. So impulses from neuron has to move through synapse or to neuromuscular junction for contraction of a muscle. Okay, so the junction between a motor neuron and the sarcolemma, muscle plasmalemma is called as sarcolemma. Sarcolemma of the muscle fiber is called the neuromuscular junction or motor end plate. Okay, neuromuscular junction or motor end plate. Here you can see that neuron, cell body, dendrite, direction of propagation of action potential. Okay, then terminal branches, motor end plate. This is muscle. Okay, so this is called neuromuscular junction. neuromuscular junction, muscle fibrous, axon terminal, terminal buttons. So this is muscle, clear. Here also axon terminal, acetylcholine. Actually neuron releasing acetylcholine chemicals. Okay, these chemicals producing moving the action potential to these muscles. Okay, voltage gate channels are there. Voltage gate channels, neurotransmitters gated channels. Action potential propagation in muscle fibers. Okay. A neural signal reaching this junction releases a neurotransmitters. What is the name of neurotransmitter? Acetylcholine. Acetylcholine, which generates an action potential in the sarcolemma, muscle site membrane. We can call it sarcolemma. Actually, what is action potential? The change in electrical potential. That is called as action potential. So impulse actually is a electrical potential. Okay, impulse. Electrical impulse. So we will study detail what is action potential, how action potential is creating, etc., in neural control and coordination. Okay, so anyway, keep in mind that basically action potential mean it is the change in electrical potential plus and minus charge. Okay, it initiate the opening of multiple gated channels in sarcolemma. Here we seen that voltage gated channels. Okay, so initiate opening of multiple gated channels in sarcolemma. The action potential travel along the T tubule. T tubules means transverse tubule at the level of Z line. Okay, T tubule, transverse tubule at the level of Z line is called as T tubules, and trigger the release of calcium ions from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Calcium ion. Okay, actually sarcoplasm reticulum means muscle cytoplasm. Sarcoplasm consists of sarcoplasm endoplasm reticulum in muscle is called as sarcoplasm reticulum. That consists of calcium. Okay, so the trigger release calcium ion from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. You see, this spread through the muscle fibers and cause the release of calcium ions into sarcoplasm. Spread through the muscle fibers and cause the release of calcium ion to the sarcoplasm. Okay, then increase in calcium ion level leads to the binding of calcium with the subunit of troponin. Increase in calcium Ca++ level leads to the binding of calcium with the with a subunit of troponin. We studied that troponin, which masks the binding site. Okay, for myosin, troponin. Troponin is a protein in what is in actin. Okay, so leads to the binding of calcium with the subunit of troponin, that is TNs. When calcium, troponin has three subunit, you know that troponin. So this subunit troponin C, TNC. When calcium binding to of calcium with subunit of troponin C on actin filaments and thereby remove the masking of active site for myosin. Actually troponin masking the binding site, but by presence of calcium it unmask. Okay, so troponin on actin filaments and thereby remove the masking of active site for myosin. Okay, the tropomyosin uncover the myosin binding site on thin filaments. Actually troponin, tropomyosin and F actin is there on actin filaments. So okay, but keep in mind that the tropomyosin uncover the myosin binding site on thin filament. Okay, so troponin and tropomyosin are regulatory protein which help to mask and unmask. Keep in mind that. Then utilizing the energy from ATP hydrolysis, ATP adenosine triphosphate hydrolysis, the myosin head now binds to the exposed active site on actin to form a cross bridge. So here a cross bridge is forming. Okay, cross bridge. Forming a cross bridge. During cross bridge formation, actin and myosin form a protein complex called actomyosin. During cross bridge formation, actin and myosin form a protein complex called actomyosin. This pulls the attached actin filament towards the center of A band, and Z line attached to this actin are also pulled inwards, thereby causing a shortening of sarcomere, that is contraction. So this is muscle contracted state. Okay, so Z line, here we can see Z line. So after contraction, this Z line come close together and H zone disappear. Okay, so that's why this myosin head forming a cross arm with actin, myosin head cross bridge with this is called as cross arm, and this cross arm forming with the myosin, that is cross bridge, okay, by presence of ATP hydrolysis, that is happening. That is, ATP is converting into ADP plus inorganic phosphate. Okay, then just sliding inwards, the myosin attaching to actin, then actin filament move inwards. Then releasing of ADP and phosphate, what will happen? It causes, that is, breaking of these cross bridge. Then when ATP is binding there, it causes breaking of cross bridge. Okay. So during shortening of the muscle contraction, the I bands get reduced where A band retain the length. The myosin releasing the ADP and inorganic phosphate goes back to its relaxed state. Utilizing the energy released from hydrolysis of ATP, the myosin head rotates until it forms at 90 degree angle with the long axis of the filament. ATP first bind to myosin, moving it to high energy state during before cross bridge formation. ATP first bind to myosin, moving it to high energy state, that is, the ATP is hydrolyzed into ADP. ATP is hydrolyzed into ADP, adenosine diphosphate and inorganic phosphate. PI by the enzyme ATPase. Keep in mind, this is very important. That is actually happening during this process. Which process? This process. Okay. By the enzyme ATPase. So, the ATP hydrolyzed into ADP and inorganic phosphate by the enzyme ATPase. The energy released during ATP hydrolysis changes the angle of myosin head into cocked position. Okay, so this reaction is happening. ATP by the presence of myosin ATPase, by presence of calcium plus plus and magnesium plus plus, converted into ADP plus inorganic phosphate plus energy. Okay, so in this position, myosin bind to an actin and activates a contraction relaxation cycle, which is followed by a power stroke. So we can see that what is power stroke. It's nothing but after the cross bridge formation, myosin bind with the actin, so actin pull inside. Okay, we can see that what is the brief about power stroke. The power stroke or cross bridge tilting begins after the myosin head and hinge region tilt from at 90 degree angle to 45 degree angle. Okay, the cross bridge transform into strong high force bond, which allows the myosin head to swell particular moment. Okay, when the myosin head swell, it pulls the attached actin filament towards the center of the A band. The myosin returns back to its relaxed state and releases ADP and phosphate ions. A new ATP molecule then binds to the head of the myosin and the cross bridge is broken. Then at the end of each power stroke, each myosin head detaches from actin, then swells back and binds to a new actin molecule to start another contraction cycle. This movement is similar to the motion of an oar on a boat. Understood? Oar on a boat-like movement. At the end of each power stop, each myosin head detaches from actin, then swells back and binds to a new actin molecule to start another contraction cycle. The power stroke repeats many times until a muscle fibers contract. The myosin heads bind, push and release actin molecule over and over as the thin filaments move towards the center of the sarcomere, sliding filament. Okay. The repeated formation of crossbridge cycles cause the sliding of the filaments only, but there is no change in the length of either the thick or thin filaments. The Z disc attached to the actin filament are also pulled inwards from both sides, causing the shortening of the sarcomere. This process continues as long as the muscle receives the stimuli and with the steady flow of calcium ion. Actually, you know that by the presence of calcium initiate the contraction. When calcium is moving back to sarcoplasm, what will happen? This contraction will stop. Okay. When motor impulses stop, the calcium ions are pumped back into sarcoplasmic reticulum. Okay, the endoplasmic reticulum of muscle is called sarcoplasmic reticulum, which result in the masking of the active site of the actin filament. The myosin head fails to bind with the active site of actin, and this change causes the return of Z disc back to their original position, so that is called as relaxation. Okay. Then a new ATP binds and the cross bridge is broken. The ATP is again hydrolyzed by the myosin head, and the cycle of cross bridge formation and breakage is repeated, causing further sliding. The process continues till the, as I told you that briefly, I am telling, the process continues till the calcium pluses ion are pumped back to the sarcoplasmic cistern. What is sarcoplasmic cistern? Flattened membrane vesicle of the endoplasmic reticulum or sarcoplasmic reticulum. Okay, the cistern is present in sarcoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so if calcium is moving back, it will contraction will stop. So resulting in the masking of actin filament, this causes the return of Z line back to their original position. So that is relaxation. Okay, so here actin filament, myosin filament, ATP breaking down by ATPase enzyme that is releasing ADP plus inorganic phosphate. So cross bridge is forming. Okay, so here cross bridge is forming. Then here myosin head with actin. Okay, cross bridge. Then what is happening? Sliding rotations during that time, releasing ADP and ADP and inorganic phosphate, which causes starting of breakage of cross bridge. Then when ATP bind there, what will happen? Breaking of cross bridge. Okay, then next cycle is starting. Okay, that all I briefly described here. Okay, then here also you can see another image shown: actin calcium plus thin filament, ADP plus inorganic phosphate, myosin cross bridge, thick filament. This also you can observe for more detail. Okay, then, okay, so this is about muscle contraction. Okay, keep in mind that the reaction, what is happening in during cross bridge formation, is that this is the reaction happening: ATP by the myosin ATPases and calcium plus and magnesium ions converted to ADP plus inorganic phosphate plus energy. So that energy is helping for breakage. Okay, so studied that muscle contraction. Okay.